Hi kids, it's time to add some data to our photogrammetric project. So hopefully you have a photogrammetric project initialized. If you take a look at the starting a photogrammetric project part one, that'll get you kicked off. We're going to add some images now to our project. So if you don't have that block file loaded, you should go to the File tab and click Open Photogrammetric Project. Browse out for your BLK file and then say OK, and that'll load that up. And once it's ready to go, we're going to want to add some images. So you can see here in the content section, we've got no images. Not good. Probably good to have some photographs with a photogrammetric project. So there's a number of ways you can add data. You can right click on your image section in your content and go add images. You can also go to the manage data tab, import data this way as well, or you can go to your good old photogrammetry tab and select the add drop down and add your images there. So you'll browse out to the folder where your photos are stored, pick the file type that those images correspond with, or you can remember type in your asterisk, hit enter, and all files will show up in that viewing window. So go ahead and select them all, say okay. It'll ask you now, first of all, if you want to generate some pyramid layers. So pyramid layers are always good to have because they increase your productivity by speeding up your pan and zoom speeds. So a dialog box will come up and ask you to, if you want to create some pyramid layers. Probably say yes, that's a good idea. It'll chug away in the background there. You can go ahead and say close, and it'll work away. You can keep on working. Now also notice in the bottom section, once you've got images loaded up, you can go ahead and check out all of the images in a tabular view. So it'll have your image name. It'll also have an active section here. So in this column, if the checkbox is on, that means that image is active in the project and participating in this project. You've also got an online section. If that image is in the folder where it's supposed to be, it'll be green. If this is red, that means the folder name got changed or the image got moved. You'll have to click this little button beside it and browse out and find the image where it's currently located. But notice here that in my pyramid column, I don't have any green cells. That means my pyramids did not get created. If that's the case, not a problem. You can go back to your photogrammetry tab, click the add drop down, and go generate pyramid layers and say all images without pyramids, and it'll go ahead and create those in the background. You can see in the bottom right corner here that it's gonna chug away and show you your progress. So you can wait around for that to finish up. Once those pyramids are done computing, you'll see that the column is all green. Also notice that if you go to the directory, you'll have a couple of extra additional supplemental files. One will be an RRD and one will be an AUX. Those are your pyramid files. Don't delete those, otherwise you'll have to regenerate the pyramids again. Also notice that in the images section over here, you can go ahead and select your image type, and it'll change it in the viewer on the right hand side. So you can go through there and check out all your images, right click in that view if you want, and you can go ahead and fit to frame. That'll tighten that up on that view. So if you have additional data that you'd like to add in, if you have ortho photos that are already generated or terrain files, just go ahead and add those in if you'd like as well. So that's it for adding data. If you want to save this interface and carry on right where you left off, what you can do is, first of all, save the block file. So go ahead and click save, make sure you save all your changes, and then come to the file tab and go save as and save your session. The session is your layout in exactly what you see. So you'll go ahead and throw that into whatever directory you want, and you can go ahead and open that up at a later date. So thanks for watching. Bye now.